To this brand new series about Redis. So Redis is a short form of remote dictionary server. Let's discuss about some of the more features of Redis before we start going into more details of each of the components. So just to give you a bit of overview about Redis, Redis is an in-memory data store. That's the reason it is very fast, because it can perform very high read and writes, as it doesn't have to store the data on the disk. And Redis is open source. So Redis also has an enterprise version, but it also has open source BSD license software, which has almost the same feature which is available in Redis Enterprise. Redis is basically a key value data store. By key value data store, what I mean is you provide a key and also you provide the values. In a typical key value data store, you can only store string type of values. But Redis is different. In Redis, you can store almost different types of data sets. Your data type can be string, of course, and it can be lists, it can be sets, it can be sorted sets. It can be hashes, it can be bitmaps. So it gives you a very high range of data types which you can store as a value. When I say in memory, you might be thinking that Redis keeps everything in memory. So yes, by default, in order to process all the requests, it has to keep everything in memory, but it doesn't mean that it is not persistent. So if you want, you can enable persistence, which means it can keep a backup on disk, and there are many configuration which you can enable in order to, you know, tell Redis what kind of persistence you want. So if you want to make it, you know, very high performance, and you don't want to rely much on the, you know, if you are okay to lose the data, then you can do a different kind of configuration which will ensure that Redis is performing very fast. But in case you don't want to lose any data and you are okay to, you know, have a bit of less performance, then you can do a different set of configuration which is available, which will ensure that your data is always persistent. And in case Redis goes down, when you bring Redis up again, you will get everything what was there in Redis. Okay, so those level of persistence is there. And we'll learn how to enable those kind of persistence. And Redis is highly available. So with that, what I mean is you can install Redis on a single machine, which is going to act as a primary server. And then you can have n number of slaves. So slaves are going to copy data at a regular interval from master. And in case your master goes down, then one of the other slaves are going to act as a master. Okay, so this ensures that Redis is highly available. And one of the key features which I really like about Redis is you can do distributed clustering. So with that, what I mean is you can have a set of n number of nodes, which n number of RAM available in those nodes, and then you can form a cluster which is going to have a total RAM of, you know, whatever the total size of RAM available in each of the individual machines combined together. Okay, so to give you an example, let's say if you have 5 machines with 1 terabyte memory available in each of those machines or servers, when you make a Redis cluster, the total amount of data which you can store in RAM is going to be 5 terabyte. Okay, so that's as much as you can distributedly scale. Now to discuss about in-memory in more details. So what is the reason of storing everything in memory? Of course, as you are aware, that when your computer has to read or when your server has to read data from disk, it is going to be much slower when compared to RAM. RAM is many times faster than disk. So that's the reason Redis is able to perform very fast. And when I say fast, it is really fast. It can process almost hundred thousands of qu- queries per second to millions of queries per second. Depends on the, you know, configuration done in your system and depends on the resources available. And also Redis provides, you know, benchmark utility. So using those benchmarking utilities, you can check in advance what is the performance going to be on your system or based on the server configuration which is available on which Redis is installed. So we'll learn about that in this session as well. So Redis can handle millions of queries per second, and also Redis can handle many parallel queries coming from different clients. So you can have many applications querying Redis in parallel, and Redis will be able to answer all of them. Again, all of these things also depend on the, you know, the configuration which has been done, and also the number of resources or the size of resources available on the Redis system. But yes, on a pretty much in a, even in a very low configurable system, it is able to handle a very high number of queries per second. Now to talk about some of the cons which is with Redis is, so since it keeps everything in memory in order to process any request, so this also means is that your the data size or the data set which is going to be limited to the amount of RAM available on a server. So which what that with that what I mean is, let's say if you have only 500 of GB RAM available on a server, then by no means you can store more than 500 GB of data in Redis, because Redis has to keep everything in memory and it will not allow you to store that much amount of data because the memory or limitation is there on the server. However, you can, if you require, you can form a cluster of, let's say, two nodes which is going to have 500 GB of RAM, and in that case it will allow you to store up to 1 terabyte of data. And also since it keeps everything in memory, in case Redis goes down and when it comes up again, it is going to have all the data, you know, lost, whatever was stored in the memory. The reason is, by default, it doesn't keep anything on the disk, it keeps everything in memory. Again, as I stated previously, there is a way to make your data persistent, and there are backups or snapshotting, or there are other mechanisms available. We will discuss about those in order to make your data loss minimum or to achieve no data loss. Okay, so when I discussed about that Redis is open source, yes, Redis is open source, and the open source version also has all the features which is available in Redis Enterprise. However, if you go with Redis Enterprise, you will be able to get support if there is any issue on Redis. And also Redis Enterprise has some of the additional features which is very good if you are using Redis on a very large enterprise environment. You can read more about Redis Enterprise from www.redis.io website. Okay, they have very good comparison in terms of what is available in Redis open source and what is available in Redis Enterprise. So we are saying that Redis is a key value data store. By key value data store, typically it means is it is going to have a dictionary kind of format. So it is going to have a, you know, key, and also it is going to store a value which is kind of description or about that key. So typically in a key value data store, we keep our key or value both in a string format, but Redis supports other data types as well. So as you can see in this pictorial diagram, the key can have a value of strings, your key can have value of bitmaps, it can have a value of bit fields, it can have value of hashes, it can have lists, it can store sets, it can store sorted sets, and so on. So it provides very big range of, you know, data types which are available to be stored in Redis. So it is not like your typical, you know, key value data store, which only works with string data types.